Before we recognize and celebrate our award winners and their accomplishments, we'd like to take the opportunity to remember and recognize an unbelievably impactful PGA professional that we lost this past year. Jim Opp was a dedicated leader that had a special place in his heart for the Illinois PGA and the PGA of America Special Awards process. During his years serving as chairman of the Special Awards Committee, he guided the group through making impactful and positive changes that have enhanced and elevated the awards process. Jim's wife, Susan, is here tonight, surrounded by a table full of family and friends, and I'd like to take a moment to recognize her for lending Jim to us on so many occasions just like this. Thank you, Susan. I can always remember a story about Jim. I had served on the board back in the early 2000s, and I came back on the board, and Jim was on, and he was an officer, and I was running the tournament committee, and Jim had always called me Jimmy. And I said, only my mother calls me Jimmy. He goes, well, what do you want me to call you? And I said, well, since I'm in charge of the tournament, I said, how about Commander? And sure enough, from then on forward, every time he saw me, he said, Commander, how are things going today? And, you know, that was just the way Jim was. He was so dedicated and honest and loyal as the day was long, and we all miss him very, very much. So we have a few additional people here tonight that would like to say a few words about Jim as well. I'd like to bring up the Illinois PGA immediate past president, Mark Labiak, to share some of his memories of Jim.
This one's not gonna be easy. But that's okay, because Susan told me she'd never make it through it, so I can fight my way through it. My first interaction with Jim came in 1995 when I was elected to the board of directors. While I always knew who he was, because I had been in the section since 1986, I really wasn't involved in the section like he was, so we didn't really know each other that well. You'd think as a great of a man as Jimmy was, and I'm a pretty nice guy too, that we'd be BFFs. But that wasn't really the case in the beginning. Back then, our board was very divided, and we had some epic battles in the boardroom. Mr. Keppa can attest to that. We had some epic battles. But they were always for the betterment of the section. Then, from 1997 to 2012, I was fairly removed from section politics. I had a new job here at Ruth Lake, where I've been since 1998. And my daughters Sarah and Dana were born in 1997 and 2000. In 2013, after coming back on the board as secretary, I started to experience and figure out what a great guy Jim Opp was. And his experience, or in his passion for the PGA of America, the Illinois PGA, and basically this badge. This badge was what Jimmy was all about right here. That passion was as strong as it gets. I watched my buddy do many awesome things in the 6 years we served together. Hired the best executive director in the country, Kerry Williams. Serve on national committees, back candidates for national office, order Italian food for us at meetings. Unbelievable. Drink the worst cocktails ever. Campari spritzes. If you haven't had Campari before, don't. Thank God I had Susan eat raw oysters and drink martinis with me at those meetings. 3-putt from 8 feet to save me a lot of money at a national meeting. Sorry that Chris Gumbach was his partner, but it saved me some money. But most of all, those 6 years made Jim Opp my friend. And I miss him. I miss his great sayings. When we'd have someone in meetings, he'd lean over to me and he'd go, "That guy's not worth the powder to blow him to hell." One of my favorites ever. But most of all, I miss his handshakes and his hugs. Godspeed, brother. You're in a better place. Next, I'd like to invite Jim's great friend and longtime Illinois PGA member, Frank Keppa, to say a few words.
This could be, Sue, this could actually end up being harder than back in September. Jimmy was more than a friend, he was a brother. I'm gonna try to stay to script if I could, but thank you, Jim, Carrie, Mark, everyone here tonight, for allowing me an opportunity to say a few words about Jim Opp, who is, again, more than a close friend. It's an honor for me to speak, but I know as much of an honor as it is for me, Jim would be deeply moved by this right here. He had many passions, his family, his friends, and of course his hobbies, which included fishing, traveling, and as most here might know, and has been said before, cooking. Man, a guy could cook. 44 years ago, I was 160 pounds, by the way. Not the case right now. But the PGA and what those three letters meant to him went well beyond the definition of passion. Those three letters represented a life of success for Jim. From the beginning, when all of us who love this game make the decision to pursue it as a career, he put his heart and soul into becoming a member of the largest and what we would all say here today, the greatest sports association. Like all of us, he would strive to improve himself at each of his career stops. But this is where Jim would stand out. He felt it was his responsibility to give his all, making sure others around him, and especially those in the PGA of America, would have the best opportunities to succeed. Never one to say no, when it came to volunteering his time, he strived to give back so much more than he ever took. His career started in our chapter. He had stints on their board of directors, and you know what? He never missed a meeting. Whether it was downstate or regularly scheduled section meetings here in the north. From there, he went to the Gateway section, for those of you that know, was down in the St. Louis area. And he continued that same spirit of giving before finally acquiescing to my pleas to come north and work for me at Randall Oaks and Bonnie Dundee. I might add on this, that was a culmination of 25 years of us knowing each other and wanting to work together again. What did Jim do? He immediately went to work serving on section as well as national committees. He then worked on the board of directors, and ultimately, he served as an officer in all four elected positions. Jim loved assisting candidates in their campaigns for national officers and was so proud to be a strong advocate for the Folds of Honor, one of the biggest charitable organizations that the PGA of America is behind. But here tonight, I wanted to let every one of you know that Jimmy was so proud of every award that was ever bestowed upon him, including the 2009 Professional of the Year Award. But his greatest love was overseeing the awards process, as Mark mentioned, and having the ability to see what great things were happening in and around the section by all of you. He would pore over all the materials that were basically sent in for everyone to look at. He would often call me and say, wow, this guy is, or this girl is very impressive. Even if he didn't know you personally, he was your strongest advocate to succeed. And I know he's looking down right now with a huge smile on his face, applauding each and every one of you for what you've accomplished. I would like to say on behalf of Jimmy in closing, those of you here tonight have done great things and are being recognized deservedly, but your mission is just starting. Along with the hardware and the recognition comes a responsibility to nurture and promote our brand, the PGA of America brand, to those who come after us. Continue to strive for excellence and never hesitate to look for ways to give back to others. Never hesitate to look for those ways. Look for them for you, for others, the association, and ultimately the game of golf. On behalf of Susan, as well as myself, thank you again for allowing me to say a few words. Jim, Carrie, Mark, and every one of the officers here. We miss you, Jimmy, but your legacy will continue. And looking out at tonight's award recipients, the PGA brand is in very good hands.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Carrie Williams. I'm the Executive Director of the Illinois PGA. Susan, welcome to your friends here with you tonight. We are honored to be able to celebrate Jim's legacy on an evening that meant so much to him. I'm glad that Mark and Frank got a little choked up here because it's going to be difficult for me to say what I'm going to say. But other than my husband and my children, I think Jim Opp gave me the greatest gift that I've ever received, because Jim was the one that called me in 2015 to let me know I'd been selected to lead the section as its executive director. And it is such a privilege and such an honor to represent and serve the 800 men and women PGA professionals that are the experts of business and golf in our section. And to get that phone call from him and to get his vote of confidence, his personal vote of confidence, in addition to the selection committees, is something that I will never forget. And there are so many things I remember about Jim, his passion and his heart and his love and his dedication. And I think it is fitting. You know, I've had Jim give me a few winks since he's been gone. We found things in pockets, I know. We've just stumbled upon things that remind us of Jim. And I think that it is no coincidence that tonight we're celebrating a golf professional of the year who started out in the chapter and who served in the chapter level and also served at the section level and hasn't missed a meeting. And I think the fact that we are going to celebrate Steve as our golf professional of the year on a night that we're also recognizing Jim, I think the parallels in their careers are fantastic. I think the parallels in their professionalism and their dedication are fantastic. I know when Steve spoke at our spring meeting, he was sure to recognize Jim and the impact that Jim had. And Steve, I know Jim would be very proud of you. And we are proud to have been close with Jim and to have benefited from him being in our lives. And with that, I'd also like to announce that going forward, Birdies for Charity, for those of you that don't know, is the Illinois PGA Section and Foundation's largest fundraising effort. It was started by Travis Johns and Chris Gumbach, one of our award winners tonight. It's raised $1.96 million in 9 years for children's charities throughout the Chicagoland area. And from here forward, on an annual basis, a scholarship will be provided in Jim's name to those pursuing golf as a career, pursuing education as PGA professionals. We are going to use some of those funds, and it was determined by the PGA professionals that play in that event and raise those funds, that some of those funds will be allocated to continuing education and scholarship work in Jim's name for people to continue on his path. So we look forward to working with Susan to determine the requirements of that scholarship, and we look forward to giving that out to continue Jim's mission within the Illinois PGA section. So on behalf of all of us from the Illinois PGA, we're thrilled you're here. We're excited to celebrate these wonderful award winners. Right now we're going to start our dinner service. Please enjoy, and we'll be back with our program upon completion of dinner.